All right, Ben Cowan-Dewar, I want to talk about the word momentum.
Well, I think, you know, momentum is something we hopefully continue to have. It's been 19 years since I started on this journey, and it's 7 years ago today I visited St. Lucia for the first time. So some of that momentum is like a rock slowly moving down the hill. And that's a little bit of the story here. I was here over 20 years ago for the first time. I played golf randomly paired with Paul Henderson, which was just amazing as a Canadian, you know, and I was a kid showing up and getting paired with Paul. And I was just so taken by the golf. And really, this place put a dent in the world of golf when it opened, with its circular driving range. It had two daily fee courses and a par three. And while that's very much what we have in Cape Breton today, it really was unique at the time. I mean, in the early 90s, 1993, there wasn't a lot of public golf. Bandon Dunes, the first course, had not yet opened. And so it was really still a lot of the great golf was private. And, you know, the land was so different for Florida, the mossy oaks, the exposed sand. And it was just such a joy to come and play golf here. And that was how I was introduced to this property. And then, I thought about buying it 14 years ago, and then again about 8 years ago, and then again about 6 years ago, and I guess maybe about 2 years ago now. It really, for the first time in all of those discussions, got serious. And we were so fortunate to be able to purchase it a year ago.
And now, of course, there's this property in Florida, there's St. Lucia, there's the one across the pond as well, but there's another Canadian property with some, again, momentum behind it out in Revelstoke. What's the status out there?
Well, so it's flying along. Rod Whitman, who obviously built the original Cabot links for us and built the nest, is doing that. And, you know, I saw that site a couple of years ago, and I literally was on the site and I called Rod. And Rod lives in BC. He obviously had grown up in Alberta in love with Stanley Thompson's Banff Springs and Jasper Park. And one of the things Rod and I bonded on was how amazing those two golf courses are. And to say they're the best mountain courses is sort of obvious, even in a global standard. But I think when I saw Revelstoke, I thought, you know, it was a site that would give Rod a chance. And as Cabot Links on the other side of Cape Breton Island from Highlands Links gave Rod a chance to do something alongside Stanley's great East Coast course. It was sort of felt like it was great. And that site is so beautiful, and Revelstoke such a special place. We're just excited to see golf come to BC there.
You saw the site so many years ago, but knowing how world renowned and how excited that golf courses make people feel, did you ever envision that was going to happen to these two fabulous spots out on an island in Cape Breton on the Atlantic Ocean out there?
No, I mean, I think, you know, it's an overnight success that's taken, you know, almost two decades, but it is, it's remarkable. I think I couldn't have imagined the level of success we've had, but I also couldn't imagine the joy we derive from seeing that community blossom as it has, and to see the joy it's provided golfers. And I'm a benefactor of that as a kid whose summer camp when I was young and babysitter was Camden Braes outside of Kingston, playing 54 holes of golf on a bunkerless golf course. It didn't help my bunker game, but it really ignited my love of golf. And I think it has been such an amazing game for me. It's been such an amazing vocation and career, and it's given me so much. So I think any chance we have to give back, we're always thrilled to. And I think when you think about what the game teaches, what it teaches in terms of values, in terms of rules, but really more than anything, I think in connecting with people and camaraderie, it's so hard in our lives to find, you know, 4 hours. I mean, there's no chance you'd book 4 business lunches with somebody in a year, but getting to play golf, you get to learn about them, you see how people handle themselves. So I think there's just so many wonderful aspects of the game, and anything we can do to move it forward, we're thrilled to.
How much fun are you having these days?
Always having fun. Yeah. There's no shortage of fun things. And again, you know, you sort of, the initial dream of building Cabot Links led to Cabot Cliffs. And you know, Cabot Cliffs went by so quickly. And I remember when it over, you know, Ben Crenshaw was literally like my boyhood idol. I had his putter and when it was over, it was sort of like, oh my God, it went by fast. So I think the biggest thing is, you know, as we've gotten to walk around with Bill and Ben at Cabot St. Lucia, really just, appreciate the moments you're in it. And again, Mark Parson was a friend who had built Castle Stewart, so to get to take that forward and work with Tom Doak, who I've known for 20 years, you know, I certainly don't take any of it for granted. And, you know, very grateful for all golf's given me.
And I think we as Canadians are very grateful for all that you have been able to do with golf in this country as well. So Ben Cowan-Dewar, thanks so much for this.
And thank you.
Congratulations.
So much. Thank you, Adam.